This broadcast is being sponsored by Akiva Walter and family in honor of the bar mitzvah of his son Yehuda Aaron, who's laying so cute on Shabbos. He's laying in the laying part of the Torah. It's very nice. She's Akiva and Carmela should see a lot of nachas from Yehuda Aaron and the whole Kehillah should see a lot of nachas. Okay, let's see the Hilah Gemara. Rav Asher shall chumash apkudim kar alpeh. The parashias in Pinchas, the discussion of the Karbonis in Pinchas, the Kohen Gadol landed by heart. Frek the Gemara, am I? Why would you do that? Niglal the Nikri. Why don't you miss to say the Torah, the Pashas Pinchas, and land it inside? Amrav who never read Yav Yeshua, Amrav Sheshes, would be Shein Gadol and say the Torah, but it's not appropriate to miss and say the Torah, but Tibur, because it's not covered for a Tibur. And Rashi says the problem with the covet is she Yehu, let me point to the Rashi, the fourth line, she Yumitzapin, the Dominakach. They sit around waiting to mish. There are those who learn that one must stand when they mish, and it's not covered to the Tibur to make them have to stand while you're mishing. Correct, Gemara? Okay. Like, I think this is the Kasha that the Mechi asked yesterday. Benaisi Achwin of Nakri, bring another Sefer Torah. Someone asked this. No, someone asked this last night. Why don't you bring another Sefer Torah? David Dayan asked last time. Benaisi Achwin, she Nigla, the Pasha Slishes. Why don't you bring another Sefer Torah like we do on Shabbos Rosh Chodesh? Rav Huna Bar Yehuda Amar, Mishim Kamish Larishon. You don't do it because if you now have another Sefer Torah, you pull out another Sefer Torah in the middle, it's going to look that it was missing. Shilayim Rechasu. People are going to say that the first Sefer Torah had a problem. Rish Lakish Amar Mishim Bracha Shaina Tzricha. Why is it a Bracha Shaina Tzricha? She ate Tzorech Lach Sar Levarach. If you bring another Sefer Torah, you need to make a new Birchas HaTorah. And that is not appropriate. Even though it was the right thing to do, try to avoid doing things where you make redundant brachas.
Is it on the Gaber or the Chefter? Why would you have to make another bracha? It's on the person, not on the Sefer.
Well, I guess if you're stopping to learn one sefer, and then you're moving over to a different sefer, I guess it would be appropriate to make a new bracha.
Do you make a bracha for yourself or on Bircha Sater for the sefer?
When a kohen gets a bimkoim levi, he makes another bracha.
Right. So, but you don't even change the sefer. That's the same sefer. So you're making another bracha anyway.
We try to minimize that. Unless there's a good reason for it, we try to minimize it. And if you would bring another sefer Torah, you're supposed to make another bracha.
Right, because it's another aliyah. And even if it's the same sefer and another aliyah, you make a bracha too.
Well, does an aliyah mean you're reading a different parsha? Or
no.
Here he also learned. He learned Achim Rosh, he learned Emor, and he didn't make another bracha. It seems like when you have a new Sefer Torah, you have to make a new bracha. Frank Gemara, Michashin Lepkama, are you ever concerned that if you bring another Sefer Torah to the Pkam? Well, Amor Rabbi Tuknacha, we're very familiar with this. Rosh Chodesh Tevis Chalios B'Shabbos. If Rosh Chodesh Tevis falls out on Shabbos, which is Shabbos Chanukah, Mavin Shalosh Torahs. We have three Sefer Torah. The current Achas Binyan Shoyo, I'm one of the Parashas Hashavua. And one is the Pasha of Rosh Chodesh, by Achas Shal Chanukah. Zok to Gemara, there is not a problem with them. Tlasa Gavri, the Tlasa Sifri, like a Pgama. If you have three different people laning in three different Sifri Torah, that's not a Pgama. But Chad Gavra, the Trey Svari, here, where it's the same Kohen Gadol who middle closes up a Sifri Torah and then pulls out another Sifri Torah, Ika Pgama, over there, there's a Pgama for the Sifri Torah. So this brings out a lot of different interesting shilas. So the first shila that we bring out is he leaned al peh in Parshas Pinchas. Isn't there a rule, dvarim shebeksav, you're not supposed to read them al peh? You're not supposed to read Torah al peh. Because there's a whole big shila in the Rishonim when this applies and when it doesn't apply. So there are those who say, if you're doing it, derech limud haTorah, that's when you have a problem. But over here, he was just reading it to refresh their memories as what to say their yom was. It's almost like with their tefillah, there wouldn't be a problem. There's other svaras that say if you're reading it to be moitzi others, then you're not allowed to. But if you're reading it for yourself, you are allowed to. Where it's very relevant to us is Kiddush. Kiddush Friday night, we say by here by Verkiyam Shishi, and we say the whole Kapitul Vayichulu. So are you allowed to read that not from a bencher? So it will be told on how the Rishonim learn over here. If you hold to be moitzi somebody else, it has to be read inside. Then maybe you'd have to read inside. But if you hold it only when you're learning and not the tefillah, then maybe you would be able to say it outside as well. There's another story to show you. If it's something that you're very, very well versed in, like Kiddush, anybody could recite by heart, maybe then it's not a problem. But there's a lot of Torah and Rishonim as to when you're allowed to read Dvarim Shevuksav, when you're allowed to read them about that. That's the first question. Second question is this Indian of Kagam. What happens, and this happens a lot, where the person who got psicha takes out the wrong Sefer Torah, and we are Shabbos Bereishis, and he took out Chasen Torah. What do? Do you mish, or do you change the Sefer Torah? And this puts the two principles that we have here against each other. On the one hand, you have Tircha de Tzibur, which you have to avoid, and on the other hand, you have the Pekamer Sefer Torah, but you don't want to mish. So this Shaila was asked to Rav Moshe Feinstein, and Rav Moshe right off the bat said that you don't have to worry about the Pekamer of a Sefer Torah if you never open the Sefer Torah. If you open the Sefer Torah and you read from it, and then you change it, that might be a Pekamer Sefer Torah. But if you never even open the Sefer Torah, that wouldn't suggest the Pekamer of a Sefer Torah. But Rav Moshe ultimately paskins that any way you go, you can't go wrong. Because if you decide that you're going to mish, then you can rely on the fact that you want to avoid Tamar Sefer Torah. And if you decide that you want to change Sfarim, you could say you could avoid Tircha de Tzibur. So Allah L'maisel, Masha Rav Moshe says, better you should mish. However, if there's someone in the crowd, Shmuel is going to help us out of here. If there's someone in the crowd who says, what's going on over here? We have to wait so long. So then, to avoid a machloikis, then maybe you should stick out another Sefer Torah. But depending, you have to know your crowd. If your crowd's going to sit quietly and respectfully and let you mish, then that's what you should do. But if it's going to lead to any type of problem, you're better off just swapping the Sefer Torah. You see, Rav Moshe also dealt with real mispalim and real people in a shul. Okay. So, the Hiddur Gemara Vayitin. Mubarak Halel, Shmoyna Brachas. The Mishnah told us that there are 8 brachas. Some of them we were familiar with the nusach, some of them we weren't. So maybe we'll get a little bit more insight now. Panu Rabbanu. Ala Torah is Kedera Shemavarachim Beisek Nesis. Which Rashi told us in the Mishnah, it's Asher Nosan Lona Torah Semres, Hachayim Notam Zechenu, the normal brach we met. Ala Avoida, Rashi told us, is Ritzei, which we end with Shoyshcha Bavatcha B'yir Navoid, Ala Ido is Moidim, that's the bracha that we make. Melech Mechel v'Shalech Lo, and Hashem Rashi told us. Well, on Mikdash b'Fnei Atzmoi, I believe Rashi told us it's a custom. I'm not aware of it. It's a custom bracha. And well, Kehanim b'Fnei Atzmoi, and the Kehanim Rashi gave us as a nusach a boicher b'Zayr Shalayim. While Yisrael b'Fnei Atzmoi, which Rashi says is a similar tefillah, v'Shar Tefillah. So, what is the Shar Tefillah that the Mishnah was referring to? Tanu Rabbanan. V'shar ha-tefillah rina t'china b'kosha milchonecha alam chisrael shrichin l'haisha. So I don't think this is a specific nusach. I'm pretty sure that it's personal. Let's see what Rashi says over here. Rashi says, k'sikna k'moisha anu oimim oisha b'tefillah. Those are the standardized tefillahs that we have. But the Shar Tefillah, Rashi says, is Shar Tefillah Shnuya b'Mishna Kachi. Rino, Tchina b'Kosha b'Lachanecha, Lama Kisrael Shetricha Moshiach. I'm not sure if this is a Nusach, or if this is just davening for our personal tefillahs. I think I saw in Masifted that it's just a personal tefillah. And then the Choshim b'Shemeh Tefillah, and we would finish off with Shemeh Tefillah. B'Achgach, okay, so I'm not sure what it's actually, if anybody's not sure what it says, but I think I saw in the Masifta that everybody would say their personal tefillah, and they would answer Shemeh Tefillah, which is usually in the brach of Shemeh Tefillah. We also can ask for personal bakashas. I'll just wait to see if anybody has an article. The Shah had filler reno to clean up a kosher.
My point is that the point at this point the condolence is like the one story for the public to the time. The word Mecca does not seem to say it's written, but that word is indeed actually in other things that are first.
Okay, so it is the word, so it's exact wording. So it's not a personal filler. It's the nusach is rina tchina bakasha milfanech alam chrishol. Okay. The aragach, and then after that, this is a very interesting halacha. And after all of the brachas that the kohen got, said on the sefer Torah, it became show and tell. The aragach kol echad ve'echad maybe sefer Torah mebeisot. Everyone would bring his own personal sefer Torah, the koyre, and he would start reading by kidei laharis chazus alarabim to show off what a beautiful sefer Torah he has, which is like a sefer Torah show and tell meet. So let's see what Rashi says, because we're missing some information. So to Rashi, laharis chazus alarabim, laharis noyav shal sefer Torah, to show the beauty of the sefer Torah, with tiferes baile, and how wonderful I am that I have such a nice sefer Torah. Hashtag is ma saifin. The owners of the Sefer Torah. So we also have a Sefer Torah to show off Shetorach Lisnois for Mitzvah. And I'm sure all the mothers are saying, today's day shine a cipher of my man Truk. He weiß ich aber Tochter auch. Right? Shenemar, it says, Zeh Keli Van Deyu. This is the Rebbein Shlomo, and we're going to make him beautiful. His snore in front of the mitzvahs. We're going to make ourselves beautiful in front of him with mitzvahs. Lulavna, Sefer Torah no, the klaf noa, it's a beautiful klaf. The yoino, beautiful ling. The lavler umanach, skilled cipher, will write the Sefer Torah beautifully. Umeirav yoma kippur mevin shom. So Rashi wants to know, how could you bring a Sefer Torah? It's carrying. So Rashi says the explanation is they brought it from before yoma kippur. There are other Rishonim who learn that there was an Erev in Yerushalayim, but they were able to bring it up. And the other Rishonim learned, like we learned in the Gemara a couple of days ago, that there's a Shita who hold, Rafram said, Mikan, that there's no Erev Aitza on Yom Kippur. There's no Yisra Kari on Yom Kippur, so it could be going according to that Shita. But a Kalpanim, it was a Kovid to bring Sefer Torah and to show it around. It's interesting why that will be done, punkt on Yom Kippur. Simchas Torah is a logical time to do it, but it was done on Yom Kippur. So we discussed that it's impossible to see the Kohen Gadol laning while at the same time seeing the animals being brought to the Beis HaSreifa because they happen far apart and you cannot be Mekayim both of them. What is the Gemara telling us? A physical fact that you can't be in two places at once? No. You might have thought that we can follow the Shita of Rish Lakish. Which means are you allowed to say, you know what, I'm here in the Azara, but I want to go see the burning of the pyre in the Seir, so I'm going to leave the Azara, and maybe I'm not allowed to, I have to remain there for laning, and I'm not allowed to go watch the way they're burning the pyre in the Seir. What was the mitzvah that I wouldn't be able to leave? My mitzvah, Baroiv Am Hadrish Melech. The more people that are in the Azara, B'shas Tikriya, you might think it's better. And I'm not allowed to leave to go to watch the burning of the pyre this year. Kamash Rulon, that you're allowed to. My mitzvah of Rashi Yesh B'riyasan. Yesh Kan mitzvah Mishim B'raib Am Hadrish Melech. Kamash Rulon, the Lav Ma'avrahu. V'yachashen Asukha. If the Kriya has already started, then you're not allowed to leave in my Rina mitzvahs. But before the Kriya started, you want to know if you want to decide whether or not you should stay for the Kriya or go to watch the Shreif. If it's a power of a Seir, you're allowed to do whatever you want. And of course, this takes us to a different Shaila. What if you're in the middle of laning? We know you're not allowed to leave during laning until they put away the Sefer Torah. Well, what if you're not in that minion and you need a Sefer and you come into the Beis Medrash during laning to go get a Sefer? Are you allowed to leave? Are you allowed to leave the Beis Medrash? So Rabbi Yashiv says that if you come in the middle of an aliyah, you should wait till the end of the aliyah and then leave. But if you came then gavra la gavra and you get out on time, then you don't have to stay until the end of the kriya. Okay, that's the Gemara. So if you need a sefer from the main Beis Medrash, you have to think of whether or not it's worth it first before you.
What is it that,
Not from this Gemara. I was saying a pesach from Balash, somehow related. The sefer called Chesut Echemed, it's written by Reb Zilberstein, who's the brother-in-law of Chaim Kineski. So he always brings anything that's even remotely relevant, like so for entertainment on the sugya, we can, he tells two things that are somewhat relevant. In Bevig de Boots, if the Kohen Gadol decided, because we learned earlier that he had the option to wear his own clothing or to remain in the Big Day Lavan. So if he did decide to do the Griyas HaTorah in the Big Day Lavan, then after he finishes, he has to take off the Big Day Lavan. And the process is when you take off clothing, the Lavan or Big Day Zav, Kiddush Adav Haraglav. And we had a Shaila in the Tanoim if the Kiddush Adav Haraglav was before he got undressed or after he got undressed. And Pashati, then he got undressed. So clearly, our Tana is learning that the Kiddush Adav Haraglav was while he was still dressed. Yared b'tavol, he went into the mikveh. All of the stopper, he came up and they dried him off. And we learned why they dried him off. He shouldn't have been begotten, stained from water. The viloi, which should be chatzitza, the viloi big dezov, and they brought him his big dezov because the next set of avoiders that he needed to do required the big dezov. The lovish, and once again, the kiddush of viraglov, the yotza, and he went out. The also es eloi ves eloha. He did the Eloi ve'elam, the Shivas Kfasim Kaminim Beneshana. So really what we should do now is the Gemara is going to be discussing all the various karbonis that are brought on Yom Kippur. So it's kedai to look in the three parshas that we just discussed that the Kohen read that itemize the different karbonis. So right off the bat, even before we look into the Chumash, we know that there are two Eilas brought, the Tomin Shal Shachar and the Tomin Shal Ben Arbayim. Those are karbonis that are brought every single day. And then there are many karbonis that are brought as an extra because of the sugya of Yom Kippur. So in the parasha of Achimoyis, which is our primary parasha that we've been dealing with, it says, "Bizoy shavi ayin al kodesh, v'par ben bokar l'chatos, v'ayin l'oyla." So we know there's a par, and there's an ayil, and there's also the seir. So this Parsha of Achamois introduces us to three karbonas. The par and the sar, which we've been discussing, which were brought in the Big Day Lavan, but there's an ayil here as well. From the Shila Zozo, from the Goyal, that's right. And now we have an ayil oyla. So far, we have two, which are the carbon tumid, two oylas. Now we have this ayil, that's an oyla as well. So now we're at three oylas, and we're at two chatas, the par and the seer. Right? We're at three and two, we're at a total of five. But there were a lot more karbonas brought. So let's look to Parshas Pinchas, where the Torah talks about the rest of the karbanis that were brought, and now we know why we have to lay it because there's a lot of information on it. So let's have a look in Parshas Pinchas, where it says we're in Sukkot over here. We are here. Here's Yom Kippur. We'll go Esar LaChodesh Hashvi Azeh Mikukodesh. They craft him Oilo LaShem Reich Nechoyach. So I lost Cheshvan. We were at five. We're at two chatos and three oilas. Now, the Torah tells us about another oila, so I'm at four oilas, I'm going to count on my fingers. So I'm up to oila l'shem rechot parven bakar echot, and then there's an ayil echot. Now, there's going to be a shayla in the Gemara if this is the same ayil as discussed earlier, but let's make believe it's not. So now I'm at five oilas, and I'm at two chatas. And then it says, kvasim b'nei shona shivet mimim, I just ran out of fingers. So it's 7 plus 5 is going to be 12, right? So I'm at 12 and 2. I'm at 14, right? And then it says, when Chazam saw this, and then the last pasuk Yeralev says, Seir Izim Echod Chatos. There was another Chatos as well, the Vlad Chatos Ikipurim, which would be a total of 15, 12 plus 3. There's going to be a Shail of this aisle. I counted them as two, but there's a Shail if there's two. If the aisle here is the same aisle as we discussed in Achamosh or not, but for now we'll assume it's not, and there are a total of 15 karbonis. Okay. And so far, he already brought the Tamas Shal Shachar, and he brought the Par V'Seir, right? That's what we're holding in today. So let's see what happens next. So Zok the Hedek Gemara. I'm sorry? You got a lot of work to do. Yeah, you got a lot of work to do. So he changes back into his Big Dezov, and then V'Osas Eloi, that's El Ha'am. And that's the shayla, if that's one and the same, if there's two islands or not. the aisle was an oila, right? The eish shivas kvasim tamim ben eshana, the seven kvasim that we just discussed in Parshas Pinchas. Divrei Rabbi Eliezer, that's what Rabbi Eliezer said. If you notice, Rabbi Eliezer didn't discuss at all the par that's mentioned in the par that's mentioned in Parshas Pinchas and the seir. He doesn't mention anything about that either. So there's two kabbalas that Rabbi Eliezer did not discuss at all. Rabbi Kiva Omer, in Tomid Shal Shachar, how you crave him, they were makriv these with the Tomid Shal Shachar, and the Gemara is going to have a shaila what exactly Rabbi Kiva means. For sure, he's referring to the Shivak Fasim Tamimim that Rabbi Eliezer referred to. They were brought in the morning before all this started. When he brought the Tomid Shal Shachar, he brought those already. And there's a shaila about the next word, Upara Oila, Mesira Nasa Bechutz, how you craven in Tomid Shal Bein Arbaim. And the power of the Oila mentioned in Pinchas, and the Shira Nasa Bechutz mentioned in Parshas Pinchas, they brought with the Tomid Shal Bein Arbaim. That was one way the Gemara learned. The other way the Gemara learned was, in Tomid Shal Shachar, you craven again, referring to the Shivak Fasim to mean him, and to Par Oila. The Par Oila was also brought in the morning, and then there's a big fat comma over here, who say, Shira Nasa Bechutz, how you craven in Tomid Shal Bein Arbaim. So there's a Shaila in the Gemara, how we read this line. Then, after he brought all these Kabbalahs, Kiddush Yad V'Raglav, who pashat, and he got undressed, he took off the big mezuzah, and now he still has to go back in to get out the kaf and the machta. The yard, the tava, all of this topic, he brought out the big day lavan, the lavash, and he put them on, the Kiddush Yad V'Raglav again, and nichnas lahoitzis a kaf and a machta, and we learned the reason why he couldn't just take it out when he came. There's two reasons offered. One is because he wasn't staying there the whole time. He just left it there and then he went on to do the Zavoida. The burning of the prayers was still going on after he left. A. Or B. is he had to make a tefillah outside. And he can't have his hands full when he's making a tefillah. Okay, and then he tried to raglav again to take off the big lavan again. Upashat miyar to the table of olam and his tabeg. And then they feel a big dissolve. Then he put on his big dissolve again. The lavash, the kiddushat v'raglav. And then he went to finish off the rest of the avoidus of the typical day. And then he finished for the day. And then he Then he brought his street clothing, the lavash, and he put him on. And he finished this incredible day of avoidah of Yom Kippur. And if he's alive at this point, all of his chassidim would escort him to his home. And he made a yomtiv for his friends. When he got out, if all of the avoiders went down successfully and he was alive, he would make a yom. So there's actually a shayla b'shoyin, who are his oyhavim, who are his cronies. So either it means all of the people who were worried for him that he should be okay when he's in the kodesh, all those people came to party with him when they saw that he was okay. The others who learned it just means his buddies. It's his buddies, you know, his kipke, his little kiddush club. So it's interesting to note that Rav Mendel Kaplan Zatzal, he was my Rebbe in first year Bais Medrash. He was a Talmud Muvak of Rabbi Chanan Wasserman. As a matter of fact, tomorrow is the Yortzeit of Rabbi Chanan Wasserman, who was murdered in cold blood by the Nazis in the Kovna ghetto. And my Rebbe was a Talmud of his. And he once showed us in the Kovit Shiurim that the Talmud Vasak Omerli, the Rabbi Chanan quotes one of his Zisa Talmidim who said a svara, and Rabbi Mendel told us, if they there Talmud Vasik Igaven, they'll say Igaven Mir. He was very proud, and he was quoted in the Kovit Shiurim. But he once told us, to feel in the Yenim Tsar, Nafmazan Amench. Of it's a feeling in the Yenim Simcha, Nafmazan Amalach. To forgive someone. So here, these people, not only did they feel his concern when he went into the Kodesh HaKodeshim, they were also truly happy for him when he came out. And that's why they came to be Mesamech. And then there's a Shiloh, what type of party did he make? Matzim Kippur, you don't have a lot of food. So either it means it was just like Hambrofen, it was just Alachayim, or there are those who learned that it happened the next morning, the day after Yom Kippur, after he had time to prepare a big Suda. How do we understand the words of Rabbi Kiva, as I mentioned earlier? Is it im tamid shal shachar how you crave it, meaning dafke de sheva kvasim? Is that how you read the Mishnah? Or maybe you read the Mishnah in the expression of Rabbi Akiva differently. Are you craving the seventh Vashem Upara Oila Bahadayim? And the Para Oila also was brought in the morning. That's question number one. Question number two. The Su Parha Oila, Rabbi Eliezer de Shire, Amos Obedle. Rabbi Lazar, Rabbi Eliezer didn't even mention anything about the Para Oila. Rabbi Kiva at least addressed it, although it's not clear what he meant. But Rabbi Eliezer didn't even address the Para Oila at all. The Su, Ben Rabbi Eliezer, Ben Rabbi Kiva, they both omitted to discuss Emur Echatas. The Emur Echatas, if you remember, they left in the earlier Mishnah, it says he left the Emur Echatas and the Seir in the bowl, that he was going to be makter later. So we haven't addressed when he's makter those. Amos Avadu. So Amar Rava, lo mishkachas la mitakanta, we're not going to find in our Mishnah clarity in the order. As Rashi says, lo mishkachas la mitakanta ba mishnah mitakanta ba mishnah same. However, we can find other brises that are more clear. Lo mishkachas la mitakanta la Rabbi Eliezer, the Tana Devei Shmuel, the Ayur B'chulu, or the Rabbi Kiva did the Sefta Shapir Shom Mestavar B'yoch. So we have two different brises, one that focuses more on Rabbi Eliezer, one that focuses more on Rabbi Kiva, they give us clarity to the order. The Oiler Rabbi Eliezer, the Tana B'Devei Shmuel, Oiler Rabbi Kiva, Kiddut HaShem. And now we'll go learn those. The Tana B'Devei Shmuel, Rabbi Eliezer Omer, Yotza V'Asa Eloi V'Ela Am. He went out, he did his aisle on the aisle of the Am. Ve'Emur Echatos. So in this price, it clearly says that at that point, after he finished laning, he did Emur Echatos. Avol Par HaOiler, the Shivas Kvasim, the Sira Nasa Bechutz, all those other Kerbonis that we were discussing, Im Tamid Shal Bein Harbay. That he'll do later when he processes the Tamid Shal Bein Harbay. So now we know what Rabbi Eliezer said, that the bulk of the Kerbonis were done with the Tamid Shal Bein Harbay. Rabbi Kiva did the Tesefta Mai, and the Tesefta that clarifies Rabbi Kiva's position is what? Is Rabbi Kiva Omer, Par Oilo Vishivas Kvasim Im Tamid Shal Shachar are you paid? Rabbi Kiva learns that the bulk of the Karbonis were actually brought first thing in the morning, even before he started the Avodah of Yom HaKippur, in the Bigdei Lavan. Shenemar Milvad Oilas HaBoker Asher Oilas HaTamid. This is referring to every Yom Kippur, not just Yom Kippur, but every Yom Kippur. You did the bulk of the Karbonis together with the Oilas HaTamid. And it's very unfortunate, because I would have wished that the Gemara would have quoted the next word. Milvad Oilas HaBoker Asher Oilas HaTamid. The next word is Ha'ayla, right? And then he did avoid the seyoyim. So the bulk of the korbanos were done in the morning. The achagach sira nasa bechut, and then the sira nasa bechut. Shenemar sir izim echad lechatos milvad chatos hakipurim. The achagach eloi veela om. Then he did the ayo. The achagach, and after everything he did a mure chatos, and then the achagach talmud shal bein harbay. So look, from my time with Rabbi Eliezer, why? Does Rabbi Eliezer hold that you do things in the morning? Zok Gemara, my time with Rabbi Eliezer, Ovid Kedichsiv, he does like it says. So what does Rashi say? Ovid Kedichsiv, Torahs Kahanim Ksiv Bereisha, Hilchach the Parshin VaYikra Nachrei Mois is earlier in the Torah in the Parshin Pnefas. Hilchach Eloi VeElo Om VeMura Chatas Basar Avodas Yom. They'll be done after the Avodas Yom. So basically, he said, first do all of the avodas mentioned in Pashas Achrimos, which include his ayil and the Emur Echatos, which are all discussed in Achrimos. You do those first, and those are all done while they're finishing up the special avodas of Yom Kippur that were done in the Bigdei Lavan, even though those particular avodas were not. Then I chose Kafel Machta, which is mentioned at the end of the sugya in Achimois, the Achagach Musaf Metamid, and then he did all the Kerbonis mentioned in Parshas Pinchas. So Avid Kedichsev, Avid Bereshit the Tarskianim, Vader Avid the Chumash Apakudim, which is referring to the Parshas Pinchas. Rabbi Kiva did the Ketanin Taima. Rabbi Kiva told us already why he holds you're supposed to do everything early in the morning, because it says Milvad Oilas Haboiker Asher Oilas Atamid. Alma, you see them here, Musafin, all the Musafin, from all the Yom Kippur, are Im Tamid Shal Shachar, you do them with the Tamid Shal Shachar. Rabbi Eliezer, Haim Milvat Chatzas Purim, my avodai, what he going to do with the pasuk that says mavat chatas purim? Rashi says that pasuk is mashma the seir chitin koydim laeloi laelam. It's mashma that the seir of chitin should be brought before his eye of laelam. My avodai, what he going to do with that pasuk? So bishlam the other pasuk that Rabbi Kiva quoted mavat other sabay kerasher lelas atamid. He can argue la via makipurim ksit. That's referring to other Yom Kippur. So he can say that Yom Kippur is different and you don't have to do those avoiders in the morning with the Talmud Shol Shachar. But on Yom Kippur, it says, Mevat Chatas HaKippurim, and there, and he'll hold that Mevat Adas HaBoiker, Mu'ir Golem Lo'yolef, the Somach HaSidro, Mevat Hanin Tash Kanim Bereisha, because he still wants to stick to his order. Don't learn from Yom Kippurim to do these Musafim with the Talmud Shol Shachar. Rather stick to the order of Achrei Mois first and then Pichas. But the problem is in Yom Kippur Gufa, in the parasha it says, "Alahai dechasav b'yom Kippurim gufei my avodai." Humi b'yale al mashazem mechaper is mechaper. It's just telling you that they're both mechaper on the same avodas. And Rashi says, "But mizitz neperkam neshus doros lahachi." Al sheyesh b'yediyah b'soif ve'im b'yediyah b'tchila. If he found out later on that he was tamei, but he never knew before that he was tamei, sira nasa b'chutz mechaper. That's what the sira nasa b'chutz was mechaper. Shenemer b'sir chat asechem b'vat chat asekipurim al mash ezem mechaper ezem mechaper ma pnimi, just like the sira pnimi ein mechaper el adavar sheyesh bo yidia. You had to have known about the tumah at one point, and we learned you knew that you were tumah before you forgot and you went into the base of mikdash. Yivash hashem avchitin ein mechaper, only something that had yidia, but it could be mechaper and something that had yidia besoit. So that's what you learn from that pasuk. Nothing about the order. The Yudah Aymer Mishmoy, the Yudah says, in the name of Rabbi Kiva, Rashi says, Echad Karev and Tomat Shol Shachar, one of these karbanos, one of the seven pasim, are brought in the morning with the Tomat Shol Shachar, Vishisha, and the remaining six in Tomat Shol Bain Harabayim, will be brought with the Tomat Shol Bain Harabayim. And Rabbi Lezer B'Shimon Aymer Mishmoy, so you see there's a whole shaila, how to understand Rabbi Kiva. Rabbi Lezer B'Shimon says, Shisha Karev and Tomat Shol Shachar, rather six of the seven pasim your makrim in the morning, the bulk is in the morning, and only one is with the Talmud Shal B'Nerbayim. My time, my Rabbanim, what is the reasoning of the Rabbanim who hold that it's both of these Rabbanim. Some say, Rabbi Huda says, that you do one in the morning, you do the bulk in the afternoon, and the Blood of Hashem says you do the bulk in the morning. So from a trach crunchy, there's two psukim. Ksiv milvad oilas aboiker, which would indicate that you are makar in the morning, and ksiv yotzav asas elasoi, which is mashma you do it later on. Tilchach avid minayu hacha uminayu hacha. Everybody agrees. Some of them you're makar with the carbon tomach or shachar, and some you're makar later in the afternoon. So in what is the machloikis as to whether or not you do the bulk six early, or if you do the bulk later, six later. If you discover avod chad to the chsiv milvad oilas aboiker, you have to do at least one in the morning, because Rabbi Kiva darshins from milvad oilas aboiker that the pasuk says by Yom Tovim to include Yom Kippur as well, that you have to do at least some of these musafin with the Talmud Shal Shachar. But how do avod avoid the siyayim? So why do you only do one? Just yoyt is designed the pasuk of all Yom Tovim. Why do you do them all? Dilma chosha chalash koin gadol. Because if you make him do so much work before the specialty avodah that he does with the big day lovan, by the time he gets up to putting on his big day lovan, he'll already be exhausted, having had brought the carbon tumid and six carbonus already. It'll exhaust him, and we want him to be fresh and strong when he does the avodah in his big day lovan. Therefore, let's push off the bulk of the musafin carbonus to the afternoon. But Blazer B'Shimon Zavar, even the Aschil, once he already started to do the musafin, as the pasuk says, "Milvad oilas aboiker, avod shisha." Better get most of them done. Dilma pasha, because we're afraid you'll get things done right away. Because if not, you might forget later. It's always best to get stuff out of the way first. Get it done first. Why aren't we worried that he's going to be exhausted after having brought so many karbanos that he'll be too exhausted to do the avodah kippur properly? The Gabi doing the special avoidance of Yom Kippur in the Big 11, he's excited for this. He's anticipating it for so long, he's not going to get tired. He's going to have a full energy to do those avoidance. So we're not worried that he'll be too tired to get those avoidance done properly. Zaktimari, the Chula Alma Mios, Chad Ayavu. Everyone seems to say that there was only one ayah. Zokt Rashi, the Chula Alma Mios, Bain Le Rabbi Eliezer, Bain Le Rabbi Kiva, Chad Ayahu the Tzibur. Everyone seems to learn that there was only one ayah of the Tzibur. The Chula Amri, Ayla Om, Mule Ari Be Ayala Kosov, Be Chumashah Bekudim Klal. They all refer to the Ayla Om, which is the ayah that's mentioned in Achimois, and no one directly addresses the ayah that's mentioned in Parshas Pinchas. So it must be that they learn that that was the same ayah. Command, who's this like? Karebi, Gitanya, Rebbe, Omer, Ayel Echad, Omer Khan, the Ayel Echad that it mentions in Parshas Achimois, Hua Amor, the Chumash HaPekudim. That's the same ayah that is discussed in the Parshas Pinchas. Shnei Elam Hem. There are two Elam. Echad Amr Khan, one that's mentioned in Achrimois, the Echad Amr B'Chumash HaBikudim. And there was actually another aisle mentioned in Chumash HaBikudim. My time in the Rebbe. What as far as Rebbe, there was only one. It says, B'Zoy Shavar Makosh, B'Par B'Chumash HaBikudim, V'Ayel Echad Laila. It says Echad. We should actually look up the pasuk inside. It says Echad. I think it's in Achrimois. I hope I'm not making a mistake. Achimois, it says, no, it doesn't say Ayalech over here. It says later on, Umayz Abbas b'nei Yisrael, Yigach Shnei Se'ira Izam L'chatos, Ba'ayel Echad L'Oyla. So it says only one aisle. So it must be that the same aisle discussed in Achimois is the aisle discussed in Parshas Pinchas. For Elazar B'Shumin, my Echad M'yuchat Shabedroi. It says the Ayel Echad L'Oyla doesn't mean that there was only one. It just means it should be the best animal that you can find, the highest grade, highest quality animal. For Rabbi Nafgilei, there's another pasuk that always says that you're always supposed to bring the best of animals for your kibbutz. Rabbi Elazar Rabbi Shimon told you need two psukim to tell you that you need to bring the best of your kibbutz. Chad b'chayve v'chad b'nedava. One if it's a carbon chayv and one if it's a carbon nedava. Utrichi need a both. We had this earlier in the Masechta. If it only said it by a carbon chayva, you think since I'm mandated to bring it, I got to bring the best. But if I'm making a nedava on my own, whatever I bring will be acceptable as long as it's decent. But on the flip side, if the pasuk would have only told us to buy the dove, it has to be the best. It's because if you're going to on your own bring a carbon, then do it right. But if it's mandatory, so you do what you can do. So therefore, there'd be a svara to argue that each type of carbon might not need the best of the best, and therefore Tzrichi, you needed the Torah to teach us that in either case, you have to always bring the best carbon you can bring. Okay, and with that, we can finish for today. Those should have a very, very happy Father's Day. You know, some people think Father's Day is a day where you're supposed to relax, then that's the mechavah you. You know, my wife suggested maybe one day a year I should act like a father and take the kids out and help around the house, because it's Father's Day. You have to make believe at least one day a year you should be a father. So I'm thinking about that.